Because tomorrow is Sunday and a lot of us are busy somewhere preaching the gospel. That's why we are trying to make everything snappy so that we can finish network, then go back home and prepare. A lot of people are still going to meet with God to prepare someone for tomorrow. So anything we do, let us just do it in moderation. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Thank God for the people the Lord has used from prayer tower. You are blessed in Jesus' name.
Amen.
That ministry will not die.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
We want to call on three people that this ministry. Please, can I beg you, if you are calling Agenda Power Ministry, put AKA there, because Agenda Power Ministry is a branch of, can they project it for us? It's a branch of Power Prayer Bank. Prayer Bank. Agenda Power Ministry, you just don't call it like that, don't call it anyhow. You put AKA Prayer Bank, okay? So Agenda Power Ministry, AKA what?
Prayer
Tell your neighbor, prayer bank.
Prayer
tell your neighbor, prayer bank.
Prayer
be careful what you tell your neighbor.
Prayer
be careful what you tell your neighbor. There was somebody in the church, they said, tell your neighbor, the Lord will sustain you. The Lord is going to do what? Enlarge your coast. The man turned left and right, the people on his left hand side are already enlarged. The man does not know what to do. Use wisdom. He said, the Lord will sustain you. Praise the Lord. So if you're in church, watch what you tell your neighbor. Look before you leave. Amen. We are going to call three people that this prayer bank, now Agenda Power Ministry, has touched their life. I'm going to call on Apostle Sarah. We all know her. Apostle Sarah. The next person I'm going to call is, after Apostle Sarah, I just want you to take that on, Minister Josephine. After Minister Josephine, we have Minister Olivia. Please and please and please, just be brief because of our time. May the Lord help us in Jesus' name.
Amen.
God bless you. Hallelujah.
Amen.
This is part of the gospel. To God be the glory. Amen.
Amen.
Praise God. I was led by the Holy Spirit to do this and display it in the car that He has blessed us on the back and the front. Hallelujah. To God be the glory. This is the gospel of the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.
Amen.
To God be the glory. I've got two of these. Hallelujah. And also, it made me to go to the printers to print this so that I'll be wearing it. I'm going to do more of this. This is the gospel of the Lord Jesus Christ. Wherever we go, we advertise the name of the Lord Jesus Christ about our Lord God Almighty. Amen.
Amen.
We can only be true Christian through Jesus Christ, not about religion, in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
To God be the glory. My husband and myself, we work hand in hand. We preach on television together for 2 years and 1 month. Hallelujah. To God be the glory.
Amen.
Constantly, out of our own, you know, money, that the blessings of God, or the, let me put it this way, I wasn't going to say it, that God has provided for us through the government, but it's not in an idle way. We're using it for the gospel. And also because of my health, I'm just battling, fighting, that I refuse to be, you know, bedridden. Hallelujah. To God be the glory.
Amen.
To God be the glory. Nevertheless, never mind. The woman of God is a good woman of God. God has blessed her. I'm not going to take your time, but if this is only what we're here for today, it is a great blessing and a great gospel of the Lord Jesus Christ. Hallelujah.
Amen.
To God be the glory. Amen. Amen. The man of God here, you might not hear. It's about heaven. You may not hear. Hallelujah.
I know what I'm talking about. I am not saying to make her happy.
Papa.
Sit down. Now.
Please.
One day, you will know why I'm here. I actually went to her house.
the volume. Sorry. It's very important for us. You know, like people buy books from heaven, the people that God. Please come and help me.
If I was not to be a prophet, she wouldn't have been anything to me.
Please. It's very, very important. Please.
But I'm telling you, I saw her. And it used to be a witch.
To be blessed by that. Amen. This is what the Lord laid in my heart, being that it was recorded from the olden days video. The Lord laid it in my heart to record it from the television. You know, I slot the CD. Hallelujah. This is about heaven. Year 2000 ago, God took the man of God in my house in heaven. The reason why God did that, people were putting me down. People were looking down, down on me. But to God be the glory, the creator of the heavens and the earth, when he values you, and somebody devalues you or whatever, or puts you down, it does not matter. It's just a matter of time. Because there's time for everything, according to Ecclesiastes chapter 3, verse 1, 2, then verse 11 says, in its own time, it makes everything beautiful. Hallelujah.
Amen.
I must say to all of us today, to the woman of God, that today is the day that the Lord has made for us to testify of the goodness of the Lord in the land of the living. Hallelujah. Amen. To God be the glory. Amen.
Amen.
I met this woman of God when a first, son Joseph, was a baby. I think one or so, I don't want to exaggerate. She was in the choir in MFM, hallelujah, a leader. She's got a beautiful voice, she's gifted, she's a loving woman, love to pray for people. She's full of, compliment. She would be saying, oh, you're a very beautiful woman. You're a very beautiful woman. And we laugh over, things. And she would say, oh, my daddy, in a way, my daddy's lucky to have a beautiful woman like you. that is a, you know, handsome man as well, you know. To God be the glory. I want to give God praise, and I'm here to testify of the goodness of God in the life of the woman of God in the land of the living. And she's so humble. I know just one few things I love about this woman of God. If you feel offended against her and you tell her about it, if it's over the phone, she said, "Oh, I beg you, ma, I'm kneeling down to say, I'm sorry, ma. That really broke me down, and it breaks people down. It makes you to be humble more. Hallelujah. Amen. This is the spirit that God is looking for in the people of, you know, God, in the house of, you know, the living God. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Many of us today were rude to each other. But this woman, she's so humble. Regardless the age. It's not about age. Hallelujah. And this is the way God made her. Hallelujah. You will, anyone that hates this woman, that person is a witch or wizard. Hallelujah. To God be the glory. Amen. As we all know, if somebody hates you, that person is a witch. If somebody hates you, if it's a man, that man is a witch. Because you're a child of the living God. Hallelujah. Amen. I give God praise. My husband was driving a car, you know, that we were driving without, you know, full license. But before, you know, we had enough license, lessons. But he used to drive in Russia anyway, a van, you know, hallelujah. To God be the glory. We saw this woman of God going to power was changed as, you know, and standing, I think, between where she lives now, that bus stop by the, you know, post office. You may not know that, but few of you know that. And I saw this lady who was about to pass. I said, "No, Papa, stop. That lady, the choir, please stop." And he stopped. We reversed. And we went where we were going, all the way at me. And she lives in history. And the children, you know, I think it was only Joseph, wasn't it? Hallelujah. This is the way I met this woman of God. And she started prayer bank in ministry in the house. And we thank God for the husband. The husband allows her to do the work of God. As long as it's not injurious to you, you will continue in Jesus' name. And I'm happy to see him here. Enjoying, taking pictures and so on. God will bless you and promote you in Jesus' name. Amen. Yeah. To God be the glory. She's a very prayerful woman. She's full of love. She's full of compliments. She's full of encouragement. Good name. That is good name. Thank you for your name. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Please, if there's anything in your heart or that you've seen in this woman of God that does not please you, please ask God to forgive her. Ask God to forgive you yourself, because we're not perfect. And be praying for her, because she's a lovely, sweet woman of God. Hallelujah. God bless you in Jesus' name. Amen. Thank God for your life. I appreciate you, and I will never regret meeting you ever in my life in Jesus. Amen.
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 Amen. Amen. Thank you, evangelist Sarah.
You're welcome. Hallelujah.
Praise be to God.
Hallelujah.
Yeah, well, our sister, our pastor has said it all, because what I wanted to say, she has said it. Indeed, Sister Blessing, she's a blessing. I really want to thank God for her life. Ever since we met, my life has never been the same. She's not just a leader, she's my mentor. She has helped me in my home, as a wife, in the home. She taught me how to be a wife. Many times when I cry, she cried with me. And I thank God for your life, Pastor Blessing. And she helped me. I'm the type of person now, I used to be shy. I know I have a calling in my life, but because of shyness, the devil wants to rob me. But when I met this woman, when I speak, she said, "There is something in you. And I'm going to make sure that you come out." And indeed, most of you that are in the prayer line, my name is Sister Josephine. I led the prayer this morning.
Hallelujah.
And I praise God.
Oh,
this is not me. It must be God.
Hallelujah.
For me to be able to pray, for me to be able to stand in front of a crowd to speak, it must be God. I must give God the glory.
Amen.
I must thank God for this woman.
Amen.
To God be the glory.
Hallelujah.
One thing I like about her, her smile. She always smiles all the time. I have never seen her from her face.
That means that you can approach her at any time.
Amen.
During even in the night, I will call her at any time. I want to thank God for your husband as well.
Amen.
Because not many men will allow your wife in the middle of the night at any time, just call like that. But I thank God for his life.
Amen.
Anytime I call Pastor Blessing, the phone is right beside her. She will pick you up and say, yes, ma'am. We will talk at any time. I just want to thank God for her life. Like the woman said, she's down to earth. You can approach her at any time. At any time, she respects small, old, no matter the age. I just want to give God the glory. Thank you.
Hallelujah. I'm one of the prayer tower ladies. We meet every morning between 6 and 7. I just want to thank God for the life of Pastor Blessing, for divinely connecting me with her. And she has really, really done quite a lot in my life. I had a lot of attack in December, January. I was falling all over the place. There were times when I was in Coventry, I would feel, as I'm coming down the stairs, I would actually feel forces behind me trying to throw me down. And things were just going wrong with my mobility. But we prayed, and that was the time of prayer tower, that I connected with prayer tower. And it's like I've been delivered. But the deliverance that I have evidenced through prayer tower is so evident that I don't know, I have no words to say. All I can say is I have seen myself. Not only have I seen it, but after we pray and I'm delivered, I know what it is that has affected me. Things that have affected me at the age of 5, I have seen them now when I'm 50. So you can imagine the turmoil that I've gone through. But thank God to the life of Pastor Blessing. And she called me general. And I call her general because she has militarily trained us to be generals. When she's unable to come online, we have managed to take on and we've raised prayer points that hit the bullseye. When it comes to the enemy, I rage and I wage war. And it is to the training that we have received. God bless you, ma'am.
Praise the Lord. I just want to say that it is not only the dead they talk about. They talk about the living.
That's right.
Honestly, the people that have spoken have not exaggerated. I've met her 6 solid years. And I can attest to all what they have said. No exaggeration. If we start to be talking about her, we will not live here. But I don't know what I will say about you. Can you ask your neighbor what would they say about you? It's a very big question we should take home today. Are they going to talk about you as a gossiper? You wake up 6 o'clock, the phone. You see, in this country, they make phone so easy, you can talk from 6 to 6. You wake up and you start gossiping about that woman. Look at her skirt she was wearing in the church. Instead of you to connect to prayer tower. To connect to prayer tower, to connect to heaven. People wake as early as 4 or 5 to connect to heaven. You are there gossiping. So can you ask your neighbor again, what would they say about you? I've given you a take-home assignment. Go and think about what people will say on your own day. Maybe people will say, that woman is bad or good. May the Lord help us in Jesus' name.
Yeah.
Can I call on the choir to give us ministration before we go straight into the world? To prepare us because we want to receive from heaven.
Hallelujah. We give God praise and give God glory. We know that we're here today for a marvelous reason. And we look at Pastor Blessing. We always see her smiling. But you never know the true journey of a person, what they go through behind closed doors, whether it's rising up or going down or turning left. Or looking after children, not looking after children, you never really know. So when someone's carrying a smile, we need to thank God for their grace.
So I'm just going to say a short contribution to usher or preach to the pulpit. I hope that you guys are blessed. You are my strength in my life. You are my refuge, my strong tower. I give you praise. I give you honor. You are my strength. Oh God, my Father, you wipe my tears when they were deep, took away my sorrow when I was empty. You are my guiding light, you're my redeemer. You are my strength, oh God, my Father. Oh, I worship you, Lord, I worship you, Lord, I worship you. Lord, I worship you. I give you praise. I give you honor. You are my strength. Oh God, my Father. Oh, I worship you. Lord, I worship you. Lord, I worship you. Lord, I worship you. I give you praise. I give you honor. You are my strength. Oh God, my Father, you put a star upon my head. Don't understand it, but you bring me through. You are my strength. You are my light. You're using me to show the light. You gave the vision and now it's clear. Your work continues to praise the Almighty. You are my guiding light, you're my redeemer. You are my strength, oh Lord, my Father. Oh, I worship you, Lord, I worship you. Lord, I worship you. Lord, I worship you. I give you praise. I give you honor. I give you honor. Oh God, my Father. Oh, I worship you. Oh, I worship you. Oh, I worship you. Oh, I worship you. I give you praise, I give you honor, I give you honor, oh God my Father. Oh, oh, I worship you, oh I worship you, oh I worship you, oh I worship you. I give you praise, I give you honor. I give Every moment.